What's going on, guys? We are back with some more NBA 2K23 with your Sacramento Kings. And in this episode, come on, man. Yeah, if they find a way to keep these guys around. Then yeah, I think we could win more championships. Because what we've done is we've almost won three straight championships. Oh, when did you sign that deal? I feel like our first game would be at home.
And this matchup, a little bit of a rarity now, Grant. Neither team in a hurry to get in transition.
Yeah, BA, these teams have almost a throwback style to how they play. They don't want to get up and down and play fast. They want to go slow. And that takes players who have patience and discipline. Tonight will be a tactical battle.
Let's check out Sacramento's starting lineup. And it's Sacramento's ball. To the inside. Rips down the breakaway.
Wembanyama throws it down.
Transition basketball. The most reliable way to generate easy looks.
The very definition of quality transition offense. If it can end at the cup, it's exactly where you want it.
Inside. Oh, got a piece of it. And stolen by Porzingis. Outside Morant. The teardrop. No good that time. Now Sacramento takes it the other way.
Three straight misses to begin the game. Not the start they were hoping for.
To the paint. And he makes no mistake. Slam
dunk. And Wembanyama throws
it down. I almost can't believe what I saw. Incredible.
I'm speechless, man. I'm speechless. And that was our AT&T 5G Slam Cam, bringing you the sauce. Now here's Morant. Gets the three ball.
Ja knocks down the three.
Morant doesn't need the three-point shot to be effective. There's so much more to his game. But when it's dropping, he's lethal.
Wagner against Morant. Steps back and shoots. The Clippers grab the miss.
That's a decent look for him. He just couldn't convert.
Out of bounds as Los Angeles keeps possession. Just over a minute and a half played here in this one.
Don't have them.
From deep.
Boy, what a nightmare quarter for this guy. He's playing right into the hands of the defense at this point. Boy, a really tough quarter for this guy. Just struggling to make shots right now.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
They know that if this guy goes off, their chances of winning rise exponentially.
Now here's Morant. His last outing, he had 24 points. Pass to Gooden. Here's the three. No good. And it's the Kings taking it the other way. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
80% from the field to start, playing with a ton of confidence.
Yeah, back in the day when I was playing, the Clippers were always an easy win. Now, LA is consistently a playoff team. Boy, oh boy, how times have changed.
Now Porzingis. The shake. First shot won't go. The Kings leading. Wagner up top, pounded by Moran. Pass to Wagner. Over Moran. And Sacramento again with the bucket.
And Wagner.
And your last year in the league, the 12-13 season, you played for the Clippers.
Yes, I did. And a great team at that. Blake Griffin, CP3, all in their primes. We won the division for the first time in Clippers history. Team record 56 wins. That year was big in the turnaround for LA.
Pass to Wagner. Three-pointer. He can't get that one to fall. And Los Angeles the other way now. Their last game, a win against the Suns. Looking to carry it into this one.
And I'll tell you, that was not an easy environment to play in. It was a hostile crowd on the road, but it didn't bother them at all.
Well, the best way to silence a crowd is with your offensive game. Those fans got quiet in a hurry when the buckets started raining down.
Now here's Porzingis. He picked up 24 points in their last win against the Suns in Phoenix.
Making a statement here early, going right to the rack. Oh, I love it.
And this is why you get the ball into his hands. Let him establish the pace and rhythm of the game.
Wagner plays it up and in on the nice reverse.
Wow, they're really being taken advantage of defensively out there. No rim protection whatsoever.
Now Morant. The three is up. Can't get it to drop.
I'll tell you, no matter what he does, he can't find his rhythm, and you get the sense he's starting to press a little bit.
Chalk up two there. Wagner's got six.
And why go away from attacking inside if the D has no answer for you?
Outside Morant.
Morant.
On target.
Bang.
That's his second make in seven attempts. Not a pretty start.
The Kings have gotten seven of their 10 shots to fall. Wagner against Morant. From downtown, they grab their own miss to the right side. And he dunks it down.
One minute I'm eventually just says I'll do it myself.
What a display of effort.
That's his bread and butter, right? Chasing down the boards.
What about the decisive finish? Great timing, tremendous force.
And the Clippers call time here. Williams has checked in for Los Angeles. Washington comes in for Moran. And with this pause, a check on the stats to show you which teams led the league in assists last year. Second, the Kings.
And what really stands out to me about this team is how they share the rock. They don't want good shots, they want great shots. And collectively as a team, that's what they seek out.
To Gooden. The three. Misses again. Now 0 for 3. Sacramento has gone 0 for 3 from downtown. Wagner outside. Over Washington. And another basket for Sacramento.
They played with fantastic energy from the opening tip.
Well, you set the tempo early, and when you get command and control of a game, it's perfect.
After Victor Wembanyama.
What a way to begin this game, dominating at both ends of the floor.
And give them credit for approaching this game with the right energy and intensity. This team has attacked every chance they've gotten.
Here's Gooden. Playing Phoenix, he was nearly unstoppable. That shot is off.
Boy, at some point you've got to realize there might be a better option standing next to you. This guy has not made one
Victor Wembanyama.
And now, almost all their points coming from the paint.
Yeah, we are team that doesn't get out and run, but also at the same time.
Here's Williams. Tipped. Wagner inside. He's guarded by Washington, and Wagner gets it to go. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Kings.
Yeah, I love the energy and aggressiveness I've seen from them on defense. They're really getting after it with all these blocks.
You know, also, they've been incredible on the fast break, taking those chances, playing with great pace.
And the Clippers call time here. And it's a completely new group for the Kings. So it's the Clippers now. They trail by 16. Washington inside. And again, no good by the Clippers.
Well, seized up just a little bit at the last second. That's when he normally converts.
Ooh, good finish at the rack on a slick feed. And the Kings lead by 18.
They have no answer defensively inside.
In the run, and he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. Everyone's still finding their footing in this early part of the season, Greg. How important is it to get off to a really hot start?
Oh, it's so important to get off early to a good start, BA. You really want to build some momentum early. In some ways, it can really set the tone for the rest of the season.
Here's Best. There's a screen.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
First free throw is good.
First free throw from Best is good. Second free throw from Best.
And so he makes both from the line. Pass to Washington. Releases from 15. And he can't make that one in.
Well, it's a make or miss league. Sometimes the Jays just don't fall. It wasn't a bad shot.
Easy.
Uses the glass on the layup.
They've controlled the paint so far.
And yeah, it's up to a 20-point lead in the first quarter.
The Kings leading. Taking a look at Sacramento. Puts up a three.
It's good.
Ooh, finally hitting one from range. That's his first three of the night.
Los Angeles has gone 4 of 9 from three-point range in the fourth. Time called here. Los Angeles decides to talk it over.
Protecting the rim has to be their top objective right now.
And the question they're going to have to answer to me is it a problem with the scheme or is it a problem with the matchups?
Get a report from Allie.
Hi, guys. The head coach for the Clippers had some instruction for his guys during the break. He told them, quote, if we'd worked harder on the glass, we'd probably be up right now. Show some heart. Show some pride. It was a very direct message. Back to you guys.
Thank you for that, Allie. Here's Washington. And the Clippers miss again.
It hasn't been all bad shots for him, but you wouldn't know that looking at his percentage from the field.
Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. Kristaps Porzingis picks one up.
Heady play to stop that easy layup right there. I mean, make him earn it at the line.
And he sinks the second. Morant with it. Drilled from 11 feet out.
Good job. Puts it in.
Morant's got 38 points.
He's done everything he can to give them a lift tonight, but it hasn't been enough.
You know, 5-point game.
Wagner with it. Porzingis picks him up defensively.
Wembanyama throws it down.
Jam. Simple and effective, BA.
Hey, with the lead, I'm surprised he didn't come up with something a little more creative. trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair. And early in his career, Porzingis was a shot creator. You think he can get back to that, Grant?
You know, B.A., yeah. In Dallas, his role was more catch and shoot. So it'll be interesting to see in a different system how active a role KP can fill, especially going to work inside.
Now here's Wagner. Holmgren takes the assist and lays it in. Nice setup. Holmgren's got 4 points now in the quarter.
I really like the way he's playing in this half. He looks so much more aggressive and confident.
From deep, Morant. And he can't get that one. So the Kings will take it the other way. 22 was their biggest lead.
And they've committed to controlling the boards, and it's paying dividends.
Here's Wagner. And that one's long. Here's Gooden.
Michael. Offensive rebound. Shot will go.
And it's rejected.
Gets rejected.
Pass to Wagner. With the drive. Six to shoot. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Throws it down emphatically.
He's got serious hops, right? You add that to his ability to penetrate, that's two easy points. Now here's Morant. From deep. Sacramento grabs the miss. Holmgren's to the wing on the left. There's the three. The Clippers grab the miss.
You've got to find a way to get yourself going in some other way, because hoisting from three is not the answer.
Left side, Porzingis. Lets it go from the wing. And it's Holmgren with a rebound. Holmgren's got rebound number 15 here tonight. To the middle. Oh, a big finish with a one-handed jam.
Well, now it's just a matter of watching the sand fall through the hourglass. This game is wrapped up and a strong showing for the Kings.
They had to fight for this one. With the game hanging in the balance a couple of times, they made winning plays, Grant.
It's all about having a strong mentality. What's interesting is that anytime momentum turned against them, instead of folding, they responded with their own attack.
And so this win marks their first victory of the new year.
Yeah, this is far from the last word in the season series. Still three more meetings between them and plenty of motivation to square things up.
He tries for three. And it's Holmgren with a rebound. I think a bucket here, Grant, would end this game.
Absolutely. That would put a bow on this
one.
You
picked us out.
Offensive rebound. Wagner, right side. And Porzingis with the block.
7'6" wingspan, sending it back. Kristaps Porzingis with the rejection.
Good. That gives him a double-double.
Pretty dime there. The kind of ball movement coaches love to see.
They can simply hold on to the ball here.
No question, B.A. They deserve the win.
Tipped. Wagner outside. From deep three-point range, offline. So the Kings win it. Boy, a nice win on the road. By the time this one was winding down, this building was stone cold silent.
And that's exactly what...
Yeah. Two for 15. Jeez. Not good enough. Beat the Lakers, and oh dear God. Pete, you're in the starting lineup. Congratulations. Lucas, nope, he's not the one. Curtis Best, yeah. Wait. You're 2-2. Yeah, although I think we are missing a lot of that depth, though. I think I want to go with young players off the bench. I know we can get a lot back for him, but I want draft picks and players back for him. Pete probably has even more trade value. Anyway, yeah, that's it for this episode, but we're gonna bring that up in a different episode. So hope y'all enjoyed, have a good one, and I'm out. Bye.